Good evening and welcome to the Roxbury Report. Several years after shaking off the blue laws restricting the sale of alcohol on Sunday, Massachusetts is removing additional barriers that have kept some Boston neighborhoods from being places to quench one's thirst. According to Bostino, an online news service, in March, Boston City Councilor Ayanna Pressley filed a home rule petition that called for Main Street's districts to be made a priority when it comes to distributing new liquor licenses in the city. Currently, 20% of Boston's 1,044 liquor licenses are owned by establishments in the North End and Back Bay. On the other hand, only 12 are owned by establishments in Roxbury and Mattapan. The bill, which was signed this afternoon, will help revitalize select Boston neighborhoods by boosting their food and drink industries. Bostino further explains that the goal is to make specific neighborhoods more popular destinations that will encourage people to spend their money there. The licenses will be neighborhood restricted, keeping the ability to sell alcohol specific to that designated area. A total of 75 new licenses will become available over 3 years. Roxbury, including Mission Hill, is one of the neighborhoods set to receive some of the new licenses. Coincidentally, Boston Magazine's 2014 Best of Boston list includes Roxbury establishments for the first time. Of note in the Roxbury section, Slade's Bar and Grill is named Best Neighborhood Bar, Merengue is named Best Neighborhood Restaurant, and Haley House is named Best Neighborhood Cafe. With each of these locations already providing alcohol on the menu, it will be interesting to see how they serve as models for new licensees and perhaps grow with the expansion of the market. Additionally, as Roxbury becomes the more popular destination that Bostino describes, there's hope that more Roxbury locations will be mentioned in future Best of Boston lists as well. Turning to arts news, the Mayor's Office of Arts and Culture and the Boston Art Commission have announced a variety of new pop-up and temporary public and performance art projects in Dudley Square. Beginning August 8th, 8 projects will take place around the square, including the Dudley Library, Gordon Park, Dudley Town Common, and on sidewalks around the area. Karen Goodfellow, director of the Boston Art Commission, is quoted as saying that Boston is well known for its climate of transformation. We are a city that moves between convention and innovation, and Dudley Square is currently at the apex of the city's transformation. She goes on to say that we believe that public art is an expression of our passionate ideals, intellectual curiosity, and cultural narrative. For more information about the projects, visit cityofboston.gov/arts. Finally, we have a tale of two houses in Roxbury, a century apart in age, but both part of the neighborhood's revitalization. The first on Beach Glen Street was opened for viewing during last weekend's in-house festival. Place Taylor, a Boston-based design and build company, made the partially finished house open to the public to preview the building before construction is completed. Although there were no walls or windows, the house was decorated with artwork organized by Artists for Humanity, Discover Roxbury, and several local artists. The JP Honk Band and local funk band Opposite People both performed and added a festive atmosphere to the event. Days later, and on Highland Street, the Kittredge Mansion was also open to the public now that its renovation is finished. The formerly abandoned house has been transformed into 5 modern 2-bedroom apartments with many period details restored. The well-attended ribbon cutting took place on Monday and included a few remarks by Mayor Walsh, who praised Historic Boston Incorporated for its work in bringing an important piece of Roxbury back into productive use.
In Boston, we don't conserve history for the sake of its looks. We do it to honor and protect the values that makes our city a great place to live. This house has a storied past in politics and activism, and it now has a future as a home deserving to many families.
Given the pace of change in Roxbury, I'm sure we'll see many more of these types of celebrations soon. In the meantime, that's it for tonight's Roxbury Report. Chris, back to you.